I am in the process of restoring a little bit this 8 mm film movie camera I got for 1 or 2 euros at the flea market. And as it is very well made, I think you will be happy to see it. So it is from the 60s, probably early 70s. Compact zoom, Cinemax 83E, made in Japan. So it is all metal. First, we have this access panel for the film. As you can see, very, very well made. Here is the serial number. So this part is in good condition, but there are some issues here. And it fits very, very precisely this door. This is quite impressive, in fact. Other side, we have a similar door with access to the batteries because there is a motor in it. This, excuse me, is a battery box. It needs some cleaning, obviously. Look at this door, guys. In a die-cast aluminium, it seems. So, the most impressive thing is when you open this front part. So, this lens is just screwed on, but I was not able to unscrew it at first try. And sadly, I tried to take apart the lens. So now it is back together. But I probably missed a little bit the adjustment for the rings. I should be able to do something for the focal length at least, correct it after, measure it and try to correct it. You can see the lens has its own serial number. As it is a nice old school aluminium color. Here we have a light cell. So if I pull this part, it opens like so. So the main issue was with this thing here. It is the battery holder for the light cell. It must contain a button cell, probably. And it is completely stuck. It is impossible to open it. And in fact, the previous owner did try to unscrew it and undid unscrewing this retaining brass nut and ripping away this wire. So I repaired this, but I still cannot open this to change the battery. And this was stuck also, it is still pretty hard. It is a sensibility adjustment. And it is still quite hard to rotate, in fact. I'm sure why, because when it is taken apart, it is not so hard. See, I was missing here 2 screws, probably a metal part. Luckily, this little window was inside. So here we have guts. Look at this. You can see it is completely of the body is die-cast aluminium. And most of the mechanical parts and screws and so on are made in brass, guys. It is quite impressive, the quality of the thing. I have an issue here with a broken screw. I will try to drill it. Here is the must be light metering also, but is there an interconnect between the 2 parts? Yes. This interconnects with this. And there is must be a grounding also, yes, at this level, grounding onto the battery case box. So it is a light metering system here. There is some fungus in this lens here, it seems. And you can see nice brass plates here. I can guess brass gear after it. And over inside. But I do not know how far I will take this part, this apart, because it seems quite complicated to reassemble. The goal is not to have a camera working anyway, because it is not very useful. It just to have it in good condition. This part was loose, so I wanted to readjust it correctly and put back the nut. So it is nice. So as they are very cheap in flea markets, these vintage cameras, I will probably try to get more of them. Either if they are in good condition for collecting, or I would like to find a lot of broken ones to take apart, because look, we have nice old school brass screws, for example. So it could be a nice source of interesting parts. But they pop up from time to time in flea market. At each flea market, I can say I see one, maybe two. But they are not always the same quality. Most of the time, they are more modern plastic ones from the 70s or early 80s. Okay, so next step will be for me to drill this screw hole and try to clean the white layer of aluminium oxidation in here. And after it, clean the battery contacts and see if the motor turns or not. So I'm quite impressed with the quality of this thing, in fact, really. It was probably not cheap back in the time. So thanks for watching, bye bye.